Hi dear students, welcome to business studies class. So today we are going to discuss about fixed capital and what are the factors affecting on the fixed capital. So what is the fixed capital? Already all of you know. So whatever amount of capital, whatever is amount of money which is involved for the purchasing of fixed assets for machineries or land or building, furniture, these are the fixed assets for our business. So whatever amount of money invested for the purchasing of these things, for that amount we can call the fixed capital. So for fixed capital we can call as a capital budgeting also. Okay, so fixed capital as well as we are going to know as a capital budgeting. Means how much amount of money is going to involved in the fixed assets. For the purchasing of fixed assets, for that amount of money we are known as a fixed capital. So that is allocation of capital for the long term assets. So which are the long term assets and whatever money allotted for the purchasing of that assets, for that money we are going to known as a fixed capital. So which are the long term assets for our business? Maybe the land, maybe the building, okay, maybe the machineries, okay. Next it can be a vehicles, it can be a furniture. So these are the long term assets for our business, to require for our business, and whatever money invested for the purchasing of these long term assets, for that money we can call the fixed assets. So in this it involved a huge cost. It is not for a small amount of cost. So it invests a huge cost, as well as this is a high risk. So high amount of cost if it is involved means it involved the high risk also. So that's why whenever you are going to take a decision for the investment within the fixed capital, you should take that decision very carefully, because this decision is irreversible. Because once you purchase the machine, it should be sustained for a longer period of time. It should be technologically upgraded. Otherwise, if you purchase the older version thing, so after some of years, after 2 or 3 years, it becomes outdated. So that's why whenever you are purchasing the machineries, any equipment, it should be updated to things, because this decision is irreversible, because huge amount of cost we are investing within the fixed capital. So now see what are the factors affecting on the fixed capital. So there are total 8 factors which are going to affecting on the fixed capital as well as working capital also. So first one, that is the nature of business. So what is your nature of business? Suppose it is a manufacturing. If your nature of business, it is a manufacturing industry, it is a production industry, means we have to produce some product. For the production purpose, we are required the machinery, and for the purchasing of that machinery, we required a large amount of fixed capital. So, amount of fixed capital, it depends upon the nature of business. If it is a production industry, large machinery should be required, large machinery should require the huge amount of fixed capital for purchasing of it. Suppose it is a trading industry, trading firm. So there is no need of any machinery. So small furniture or any 2 or 3 equipments may be required for the trading industry. So for that, there is a less fixed capital should be required. So it depends upon whatever the capital, fixed amount of capital, it depends upon the nature of business. Second, it is a scale of operation. So what is the scale of operation for your business? It is a small scale, medium scale or large scale. Suppose it is you are producing a TV sets, and your industry daily it produces 10 pieces of TV per day. So it becomes a small scale industry. So whatever amount of money which is required for the production of 10 pieces per day, so whatever machinery it is required, it is less. Suppose if you want to produce 100 pieces of television set per day, so it required a more machinery at that time. So that time your fixed capital purchasing for the purchasing a fixed machineries or fixed assets, it required more. So that's why it required the more capital. So it depends, your fixed capital amount, it depends upon what is the scale of your business. If you are producing with a small scale, required a less amount of money for the fixed capital. If you are producing with a large scale, required a more amount of money for the fixed capital. Next, technique of production. Technique of production means there are 2 techniques. One is a capital incentive and another is a Capital incentive means what? Every process, otherwise every function of your production industry, it is run along with the machineries. If machineries are more, workers are less. If machineries are more, workers are less. If machineries are more means we have to purchase the more machineries for it. So amount of our investment within the fixed capital is more. So that is the capital incentive. For capital incentives of production, you require more fixed capital because machineries are more. Labor incentive means what? Less machineries and more worker should be there. More labor should be there. Okay. So if it is less machinery, so whatever amount for the purchasing of that machinery, it required the less amount of capital within the fixed capital in techniques of production. Next one, technology upgradation. If your industry, otherwise it is your industry, there is a need to upgrade along with the technology, so that time it should require a more fixed capital. If it is not like that, if technology is sustained for a longer period of time, so that time it required the less working capital. Take example, suppose mobile phones. Within a 2 days, the upgraded things are going to be changing within the mobiles. So if such a kind of industry you have, you should change according to the technology. You should change your machineries according to that. Okay, because to sustain within the competition. But take another example, sewing machine. Sewing machine, you can call it. Sewing machine. So within 2 days, the technology of sewing machine is not going to be changed. So it sustains for a longer period of time. So if your industry is related with the debt, so you can sustain what is your fixed capital, it should be required less there. And if the technology is changing within 2 or 3 days, or frequently it is going to be changing, that time your fixed capital required should be more. Next, growth prospectus. Growth prospectus means if you want to add a new product within your business, okay, otherwise you want to increase the scale of your business, you are producing 10 pieces, then you want to start the 100 pieces. So that is the growth of your business. For growth of your business, you require a huge capital, you require a large amount of assets. Okay, for purchasing of more asset, large amount of assets, you should require a large fixed capital. Next, diversification. So diversification means changing the line of your business. Means that initially you are producing the sugar, you have the sugar industry. Then you decided that you are going to produce the textile. You want to start the textile industry. So that is a changing line of business. So that time also you require the large amount of fixed capital. Because whatever machinery required for the new industry, it may be a different thing. Next, financing alternatives. So there are a lot of financing alternatives. You have to take the advantage of it rather than investing more amount of fixed capital for the purchasing of fixed assets. You can take it the best option to choose the financing alternative. So financing, source of finance, we are already studying in chapter number 8, source of business finance in last few first year. Okay. So there is a source, that is a lease financing. Lease financing is on rent basis. So instead of purchasing a building, you can take a building on rent basis. Instead of purchasing a machinery, you can take a machinery on rent basis. Okay. So instead of purchasing a vehicle, instead of purchasing a furniture, you can take it on rent basis or lease basis. So you can choose that option also. So that time you require the less fixed capital. And last one is the level of collaboration. So level of collaboration means what? If you entered into the joint venture with another company, if you are start to work with the another company, so that time you can use the resources of another company. If you want to collaborate with another company, you can use the resources, you can use the machinery, furniture, building of another company. So that time fixed capital can be required less amount. Because if rather than the purchasing of new machinery, you can use the new another machinery of other company. If you enter into the joint venture or collaboration, so that time fixed capital should be required less. So these are the fixed capital and factors affecting on the fixed capital. I hope you got the clear concept about what it means fixed capital and what are the factors affecting on fixed capital. Suppose if you have doubt, we will clarify your doubt within the live class. So thank you so much. Bye bye.